Welcome back. So we are leaving Battle Mountain and driving to Ukiah, Oregon on 395 South. 158 miles to Burns. And it's like I have 40 minutes of memory card left. I forgot to delete some of my old videos, so I might need to get the laptop out and do that. Find another picnic area like that and sit down at the picnic table. Or I'll just put another memory card in. We'll try and stop in Ukiah if we don't find anything. Here's the summit of Battle Mountain, 4,270 feet. Actually, a bunch of scenic byways in this area I need to check out, but that's after I go to Steens Mountains area. We'll see if I come back this way. I could save it for another trip. Cell service, by the way. The truck still has it. My phone does not. The truck range is awesome because I'm pretty sure the antenna is really powerful. I love forests like this that are not super thick and you can kind of see through them. There's smoke off to the east. I think there might be a little fire somewhere in the area. I hope that's not from the Hell's Canyon area and Washington fires. I thought those were all almost out, it looked like. Battle Mountain Scenic Corridor. Wow, look at their house there they have. So Albee is 6 miles to the left. Ukiah is a neat historic western town. people and cows all of a sudden. Big old steer, longhorn steer out there with the regular cows. Didn't go down much from that Battle Mountain Pass. I think we're definitely in the high plateau desert area now. There are tons of cows here. Just put another memory card in because I don't want to stop to copy files now. I need to delete the old ones. I could do that. I don't need to copy anything. Maybe I'll do that. Oh, I see haze. Hopefully this is the smoke from the little fire in the area and not from California or the Cascades of Oregon. Because if it's from far away, then there's going to be a lot of smoke, unfortunately. Make me sad. Got to be from a fire close by to change that drastically. Has to be. I hope. Because I should drive through it fairly quick if it is. It's not a big fire. Lost cell service now. Even the truck only has one bar. sick. I had to turn the air recirculate on. I was starting to smell it. It's definitely close. Back up into the forest again though soon. Road gets really twisty. Ah, Ukiah is left in half a mile. So we are not, I don't think we actually go through Ukiah, unfortunately. Route if you go north from there. So this is the Ukiah Dale Scenic Corridor. Ugh, it's crazy how smoky it got all of a sudden. Forest again. Ah, there's a state park in half a mile left. Might check that out. Smoke though, that would not be fun. Oh my god, and it's busy. Actually, there are some spots. Let's drive through it real fast and I will show you. So, this is the Ukiah Dale State Park Campground. If there's a day use area, we'll sit there for a few minutes and take care of these files. So it's $10 to camp here. It's not too bad. It's flat. It's a nice little van, Mercedes van. Day use area. It looks like, ah, here's a rooftop tent. It's the cheaper version of mine by a different company. So you can't put anything on the roof of that one when it's closed. It's like plastic. It's not a bad tent, I'm sure. And it's like half the price of what I paid.
In 1/4 mile, turn left.
Yeah, there is no no day use area here, so we're gonna leave. If it had cell service, I would be tempted to stay here. Like, it definitely looks nice and quiet. Except they might have mosquitoes. There's some stagnant water down there, it looks like.
Turn left to US 395.
Well, I'm gonna stop this video. We might start a new one. I don't know. We'll see. But that was Ukiah Dale State Park Campground. 95.